हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ सायली खटांगळे फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजिनियरिंग, फैकल्टी ऑफ विद्यावर्धिनी इंस्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी पाल. दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजिनियरिंग ऑफ थर्ड सेमिस्टर ऑफ MSBT सर्कुलम. Today we are discussing about the course name is Basic Electrical and Electronics Engineering. The course code of this subject is 22310 and program name is Mechanical Engineering Program Group of third semester. Basic Electrical and Electronics Engineering, in that case half section is basic electrical and half section is about basic electronics engineering. The half section of basic electrical engineering are teaching by me and half section are taught by Mathode madam from ENTC department. So let's see the what is electrical engineering. Means what? The branch of engineering which deals with generation, transmission, distribution and utilization of electrical engineering. In simple word, in our home appliances, electrical energy are used in various application like bulb, cooler, fridge, fan or heater. We have to use electrical energy. So firstly, electrical power is generated, then the power is transmitted by transmission line, then power is distributed, then we get the electrical energy in our home appliances. Then we utilize the electrical energy in various appliances like bulb, fan, heater, cooler, fridge or like that. म्हणजे काय, आपल्या घरामध्ये आपण इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जीचा यूज कसा करतो? तर इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी कशी येते आपल्या घरामध्ये? पहिला तर त्याचं पहिला इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जीचं जनरेशन होतं. ते जनरेशन झालेली इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी ट्रान्समिशन होते. कशा थ्रू? तर ट्रान्समिशन लाईन आहेत, त्याच्या थ्रू इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी ट्रान्समिट होते. ट्रान्समिशन झाल्यानंतर त्या इलेक्ट्रिकल लाईनचं डिस्ट्रीब्युशन होते. तर ते डिस्ट्रीब्युशनचे जे पॉईंट आहेत ते आपल्या इलेक्ट्रिकल होम घरामध्ये येतात. ते आपण कुठे कुठे यूज करतो? तर बल्बमध्ये, कूलरमध्ये, फ्रीजमध्ये, फॅनमध्ये और एनी अदर इलेक्ट्रिकल अप्लायन्सेस आर यूज्ड इन दिस बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल स्टडीज फॉर मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग. सो व्हाय द मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग स्टुडंट आर स्टडीड द बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल? बिकॉज ऑल द मशीन्स इन मेकॅनिकल आर डज नॉट स्टार्ट without any electrical supply. So what, which type of supply and also various parameters in the electrical of basics like that voltage, current are discussed in later. And in half section of this lecture also you have to study the information of basic electronics. So you have to learn about information of basic electrical and also basic electronics engineering. Next, these slides is a course outcome. So what is mean by CO is the course outcome. That is, student will learn these things after the completing the course. So after completing the basic electrical and electronics course, we will learn and achieve these outcomes. So first one is the use principles of electric and magnetic circuits to solve engineering problem. Second, determine voltage and current in AC circuits. Third one is a connect transformers and electric motors for specific requirements. Next is a identify electronic component in electric circuits. Fifth is a use relevant electronic components safely. Sixth one is a use relevant electric or electronic protective device safely. So, in that first case, principle of electric and magnetic circuit to solve engineering problem means what? This is the problematic course outcome. Means electric and magnetic all parameters are studied and then solved on the that problem. Second one is the voltage and current. The which is the relationship between voltage and current, how to use voltage and current in various parameters in machines. Then third one is a connect transformer and electric motor for specific requirements. In third CO, we have to check and test the equipment. Means what? We have to learn transformer and electric motor in basic, and then we have to connect as per the connection diagram and see the result on it. The first three CO are based on the basic electrical engineering, and the fourth, fifth and sixth course outcomes are for the basic electronics engineering. Fourth one is what? Identify electronic component in electric circuit. म्हणजे जे जे आपल्या इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंपोनेंट आहेत ते इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किटमध्ये कोणते कोणते आहेत ते कसे ओळखायचे ते आपण डिटेलमध्ये स्टडी करणार आहोत. फिफ्थ वन इज वॉट? यूज रिलिव्हंट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंपोनेंट सेफली. ते इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंपोनेंट हाऊ टू यूज सेफली विदाउट एनी डॅमेज हे आपण ह्या फाईव्ह कोर्समधून शिकणार आहोत. लास्ट वन इज यूज रिलिव्हंट इलेक्ट्रिक और इलेक्ट्रॉनिक प्रोटेक्टिव्ह डिवाइस सेफली. म्हणजे कोणतंही इलेक्ट्रिक और इलेक्ट्रॉनिक प्रोटेक्टिव्ह डिवाइस जे यूज करणार आहोत ते आपण सेफली अँड प्रॉपरली कसं इम्प्लिमेंट करणार आहोत आणि त्याचा यूज केल्यानंतर आपल्याला त्याचा वापर त्या इन्स्ट्रुमेंटसाठी कसा होणार आहोत हे सगळं आपण बघणार आहोत. सो नाउ वी आर सी टीचिंग अँड एक्झामिनेशन स्कीम. टीचिंग इज एक्झामिनेशन स्कीम इज सेड दॅट द टोटल मार्क्स ऑफ कोर्स इज अ 150 मार्क्स. फर्स्ट इज अ ESE इज इक्वल टू 70 मार्क्स. मीन्स वॉट? ESE इज एंड सेमेस्टर एक्झाम. 70 मार्क्स थेरी पेपर which is the end of the semester. Next one is a PA, progressive assessment. It includes 30 marks. There are two progressive assessment. One is the test and second one is for a micro project in that. Next one is progressive assessment for 50 marks. For practical, 20 marks for your manual and 20 marks for your oral exam. So that total weightage or total marks of this subject is 150 marks. So it is very important subject for your curriculum. Next. So in next, we have to discussing the syllabus. First unit, electric and magnetic circuit. I recommended you to give your notebook and write the syllabus at least unit and name and what the weightage of this unit. And in the next video or next session, we will easy to know what is the weightage of each unit in the syllabus. So first discuss unit of first electric and magnetic circuits. Have to obtain 8 marks weightage. It includes first one is explain the given technical terms related to electric and magnetic circuits. Second one is interpret the given BH curve. Third one is interpret hysteresis loop of the given material. Fourth one is apply Fleming's right hand rule and Lenz's law for determination of direction of induced EMF in the given situation. In first one, the technical terms related to electric and magnetic circuit. Then which one of the electric and magnetic circuit technical terms? Electric circuit has voltage and current. Then in magnetic circuit, magnetomotive force, flux. These all the terms are defined properly, and also the expression how to define these terms are explained in the next session. In interpret 2-3, these points are the magnetic circuits are explained in detail, and the fourth one is the Fleming right hand rule and Lenz law for determination of direction of induced EMF. In that case, we have to learn about the EMF term, and these term are apply by using Fleming's right hand rule and Lenz law. This is the fourth one, is the problematic point in that unit. Next unit is AC circuit. Its wattage of 12 marks. It includes first is explain attributes of the given AC quantity. Second one is find current and voltage in the given series and parallel AC circuits. Third one is drive the current and voltage relationship in the given star and delta connected circuits. Fourth one is determine the current and voltage in the given star and delta connections. Fifth one is a solve simple numerical problem related to the given AC circuit. आता ह्या आपण चॅप्टरमध्ये ए सी सर्किट्स म्हणजे काय आहेत, ए सी म्हणजे काय, तर अल्टरनेटिंग करंट सर्किट्स. ह्याच्यामध्ये ए सी सर्किट्स कन्स्ट्रक्शन, देन वी स्टडी द ए सी सर्किट्स पॅरामीटर्स, देन वी स्टडी करंट अँड वोल्टेज इन सेरीज सर्किट, ऑल्सो इन पॅरलर सर्किट. देन वी हॅव टू डिटेल स्टडी इन दॅट युनिट. Then the third, fourth and fifth are the numerical session. In that case, all the relations and their problems are studied, and also practicals are in that case. Next one is a unit 3, transformer and single phase are of wattage of 16 marks. In that case, first one is explain with sketches the construction and working principle of the given type of single phase transformer. Next is explain with sketch the working principle of the given auto transformer. Third one is describe with sketch the construction of the given single phase motor. Fourth one is explain with sketches the working principle of the given single phase induction motor. So we have to learn in that unit is construction of transformer, also the single phase. These are the two different session. In transformer we have to study first of all the construction, then the EMF equation, then that numerical, then the connections are how to connect a transformer in our practical session. Then we studied single phase, how to connect a single phase transformer, then working principle of single phase transformer. In next in second point we have to discuss the working principle of a auto transformer, also sketch the auto transformer diagram, and in detail how to auto transformer our work. In third session we have to study describe and sketch the construction of the single phase motor. Manje kay tar single phase motor kashi draw karaychi, tyacha एक्सप्लेनेशन काय आहेत, त्याचा यूज काय होतो, त्याचा ॲडव्हान्टेजेस काय आहेत, हे सगळं आपण थर्ड पॉईंटमध्ये ह्या युनिटचे शिकणार आहोत. आणि फोर्थ पॉईंटमध्ये काय शिकणार आहोत, तर सिंगल फेज इंडक्शन मोटरचं कन्स्ट्रक्शन काय आहे, त्याचं वर्किंग प्रिन्सिपल काय आहे आणि त्याचे युजेस काय आहेत, हे सगळे पॉईंट आपण ट्रान्सफॉर्मर अँड सिंगल फेज ह्या युनिटमध्ये शिकणार आहोत. इन दॅट सब्जेक्ट 6 युनिट आर टेकन, बट फर्स्ट 3 युनिट आर फॉर बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल अँड 4th, 5th, 6th आर फॉर बेसिक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजिनिअरिंग. सो वी हॅव टू स्टडी फॉर बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इज फर्स्ट 3 युनिट. दीज 3 युनिट आर टेकन बाय मी, सायली खटांगळे मॅडम. सो थँक यू फॉर लिसनिंग अबाउट दिस लेक्चर. नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी हॅव टू डिस्कस युनिट बाय युनिट, मीन्स फर्स्ट युनिट वी हॅव टू स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट.